Nearly every living organism that exists dies at some point in time. Finding a way to cheat death or achieve immortality has piqued human interests for eons. We're already actively trying to crack the code of aging. Some humans even voluntarily freeze their bodies to be woken up at a later date, hoping that any medical advancements made would be able to save them. But what if we could make a digital replica of our consciousness? What if we could upload our minds into a computer, being able to transfer our minds across great distances or between different bodies? This would be an unprecedented step for humanity. It sounds crazy, but work has already begun. Most complex life forms have some form of consciousness. Consciousness is our ability to experience things. It's an awareness of our environment, and at an advanced level, as seen in humans, it also includes self-awareness. There are many theories that try to explain consciousness, but for this video, we're going to assume that consciousness is a phenomenon that emerges in the presence of a sufficiently complex neural network. In this case, our brain. To transfer or upload our consciousness, we would first need to tackle the problem of simulating the brain. The main challenges we face today include understanding and then scanning the human brain in enough detail to perfectly recreate a mind artificially. The human brain contains over 86 billion neurons, each and every one of them bridged by at least 100 trillion synapses. Firstly, we must obtain the connectome of the human brain. So, what is a connectome? The connectome of an organism is basically a map of all neural connections within the organism's nervous system. It's safe to say that the connectome of the human brain is exceptionally complex. There are hundreds, if not thousands, of different types of neural connections in use, with each working in slightly different ways. Besides the precise one-to-one connections between neurons, some neurons even affect multiple other neurons simultaneously through the use of neurotransmitters. If you're not completely getting what's going on, don't worry. Scientists don't either. Your brain works in weird and wonderful ways. We just don't have a sufficient enough understanding of how the human brain works to know what exactly to map so we can copy one's mind. If we do manage to understand the relationship between different neurons and how our brains work as a whole, we now have the problem of actually scanning it. We currently don't have the technology to image our brains with the resolution to determine the details of individual synapses. We're talking about non-invasive methods here, so if you want to kill somebody and cut up their brains, we're not judging. We would need fundamental breakthroughs in imaging technology to reach resolutions in the order of microns, a thousandth of a millimeter. Currently, our best non-invasive scanning method is the MRI, which has a resolution of about half a millimeter. It's safe to say that it's gonna take a while before we figure our brains out. Let's take a step back and start with something less ambitious. What if we could map the connectome of a smaller, less complicated organism and simulate it with a computer? What if we could create virtual life? The Open Worm Collective, taking pride in its name, has done exactly just that. Mapping the brain of the C. elegans nematode, which is basically just a mini worm. While a worm may seem especially insignificant, it's a stepping stone to understanding our brain. So, with this intention, Open Worm started in 2014 with purely one goal: recreate the brain of a roundworm virtually. The C. elegans measures in at a length of 1 millimeter, with its connectome only consisting of 302 neurons. This is in stark contrast to humans. However, this simplicity has allowed scientists to make a one-to-one mapping of every single cell and its function within the organism. Despite having a small brain, the worm displays primitive and complex behaviors, such as feeding, locomotion, mating, learning, and social behavior. With the connectome mapped, a simulation of the organism was enabled. The scientists then attempted to use its brain in a robot that they developed. This robot had all the physical characteristics the worm's brain would expect it to have, such as a sonar sensor as a nose, motors for the motor neurons, and whatever it took to get the brain to feel at home in its new shell. Amazingly, the roundworm virtual brain moved the robot without any directive being programmed into the robot. The robot behaved similarly to how they observed the roundworm to. For example, the worm was observed to stop moving if the nose was stimulated. The robot could also avoid obstacles and move without any motors directly spinning its wheels, but by instead wiggling its body. Naturally, the simulation wasn't an exact representation as to what a roundworm would do, as the robot was developed with its primary focus being locomotion. They don't mate, socialize, or feed on human flesh just yet. This research is extremely impressive and promising, but we'll probably develop an AI singularity and end human civilization long before we get to simulate a human brain. But what if we could get past all these hurdles? What if we finally figure out how our brains work, and more importantly, what consciousness actually is? Enter the future, where we can now emulate ourselves. What are the implications of a feat this great? In the Netflix cyberpunk series Altered Carbon, the idea of having your consciousness inside of a chip or stack inside of your neck is central in the world portrayed. You might be thinking that copying your brain and destroying your old self means that you're basically killing yourself. However, in this world, most people alive have their consciousness transferred to their stack when they're babies, so before they become self-aware. This would basically mean that most of a person's life is experienced with their stack, redefining which mind is the real you. The concept of having a stack effectively warrants immortality because once your body dies, you can just implant your stack into another body. This all sounds great, right? The idea of transferring your stack expedites interstellar travel by simply sending your mind to a body on another planet. Murder victims can now testify after they die. However, this also enables social disparities in which the rich can become unimaginably wealthy, and access to getting new bodies is based on social class. The ethics behind mind uploading are undoubtedly fascinating, and the show itself is definitely one we recommend watching. Let us know your thoughts about this topic in the comment section below. If you found this video interesting, feel free to like the video and subscribe for more. It's free, and that's a great price.